सजीवं साद्वैतं साधूतं परिजनासहितं श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्यदेव श्रीराधाकृष्णपादात् सहगणा ललिता श्रीशखान्वितामश्च नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामीति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषः शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशधारिणे नमो महाबलिनाय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनामिने गौरदेश नमः हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांता राधा कांता नमोस्तुते ताप्त कांचना गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी विश्वानुसुते देवी रमनामि हरि प्रिये नीलाचला निवासाय मिथ्याया परमात्मने बलभद्रा सुभद्राभ्या जगन्नाथाय ते नमः पंचतत्त्वमकं कृष्णं भक्तरूपा स्वरूपकं भक्तवतारं भक्ताख्यं नमामि भक्तशक्तिकं पंचकल्पतरूपस्य कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा राम राम हरे 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 कृष्णा आई वेलकम यू फॉर टुडेज सर्विस प्रोग्राम सो टुडेज टॉपिक इज हाउ वी कैन रिसीव कृष्णास मर्सी and how we can develop attachment for chanting the holy names of Lord Shri Krishna. We have to understand and we have to take the lessons from the previous acharyas. If we read Shishtashtakam prayers where Krishna mentions in the form of Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is the Mahabhadanaya avatar and who came here, appeared in this Kali Yuga for giving us the supreme object, the supreme goal of human life, which is Krishna Prema. Lord Chaitanya gave us a very simple method for developing taste, for developing the dormant love of Shri Krishna in our hearts. We can awaken that dormant love of Shri Krishna by sincerely chanting the holy names of Lord Shri Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
When we chant this mantra with full of love and devotion towards Sri Krishna, in the dormant love of Shri Krishna awakens in our heart. What Chaitanya says in the Shishtashtakam prayers, Srinadapi sunichena karorapi shaheshnana amadina manadena kechanya sadahari. So this should be a note of a devotee. Srinadapi sunichena, which means we should be humble like a blade of a grass, which means in the fields there are so many grass. You step on that grass, someone can step on that grass, someone can spit on that grass, and the dogs or the animals there or some
people pass urine, pass water on that particular grass. But a grass never protests. So similarly, a devotee, the grass almost in a bending form, right? He never stands like this. Oh, how dare you? The grass never protests. The grass is very humble. So we have to become humble like a blade of grass. Then Lord Chaitanya says in the next line, the meaning of taro means the tree. So you have to be tolerant like a tree. A tree in the summer heat, in the day, starts in the rays of heat, full rays of sun. And to give a shelter, and take like in the banyan tree or the knee tree, if you go under that tree, feel like shelter, let it be peaceful. So a tree gives a shelter in the rain. The tree gives shelter to the birds who are taking shelter, who make the nest in that particular tree. The tree gives them shelter by protecting from the water, from the rain. The tree gives us fruit to eat, the food to eat, right? In the winter, the tree sagged. In the cold atmosphere, day and night, the tree never complains. But in winter, what he gives to us? He gives us food to eat, right? Similarly, a devotee should be tolerant. Whatever happens in our life, whatever difficulties come in our life, whatever problem come in life, I will take the shelter of Govinda, the Adi Purusha. Brahma says in Brahma Samhita, Vishvara Parama Krishna Sachitara Dhavigraha Anajiradhi Govinda Sarapar Nakara. When Brahma is saying to Lord Krishna, I say in the first sloka of Brahma Samhita, Ishvara Parama Krishna. Krishna is the supreme personality of God. Ishvara Parama Krishna. Sachit Ananda Vigraha. The form of Krishna, Sat. Sat means full of eternity. Chit, full of knowledge, and bliss, the supreme object of all happiness. And Vigraha means body. Ishvara Parama Krishna. Sachit Ananda Vigraha. Another Adi Govinda Sarvakarika, and you, Krishna, you are the cause of all causes. And then, after this look, Brahmaji starts describing the Goloka, the Trikavidhan. And after, in each sloka, the last line, Brahmaji says, Govinda Madhu Rishabdham Hamajan, O Govinda, with Adi Purusha, you are my Lord, I surrender to you, I worship you, I adore you. Similarly, a devotee should be tolerant. A devotee should, in every circumstances in life, a devotee should see it as a mercy of Krishna. You can see the example of Kunti Maharaj. Kunti Maharaj is praying to Krishna, oh Krishna, give me more and more troubles, make my life hell. Give me more and more and more sufferings. Because when you give me the sufferings, in that time I surrender it to you. I remember you constantly. And that is the secret of spiritual life. To never forget Krishna and to always remember Krishna is the essence of the spiritual life, is the essence of all the Vedic scriptures. To never forget Krishna and to always remember Krishna. This was to never forget Krishna and to always remember Krishna is very simple. But to apply it in our life, we need to develop this mode of Krina, the Bhisani, Jaina, the Rora, Bhisha, Hishuna, Amanina, Manadena, Kitanya Salami. So, Amanina, Manadena. I'm not here for name and fame. I'm not hungry for name and fame. I don't want name and fame.
and what you want. And what I want, if you don't want me, then what you want? I want peace and less about money. I want to chant the name of Lord Sri Krishna constantly. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. In one sloka of Sri Chaitanya Shishtashtra, Lord Sri Krishna says, Na dhanam, na jhanam, na sundarmem, kavita hama jadati isha kamae, mama janmani, janmane shure, bhutat bhakti rahitu gitwe. Then Lord Chaitanya says, a devotee should think like this, Na dhanam, I don't want wealth, I don't want money. Na dhanam, na jhanam, I don't want to take births in high families, I don't want to take births on people. Na dhanam, na jhanam, na sundarin. I don't want gold rings in my life. Then what do you want? Na dhanam, na jhanam, na sundarin. Kavita majabat isha kamae. Mama janmani janmani shwade bhodat bhirahe tuki hoi. After, oh Lord, if you want me to take birth, I'm ready to do it. But I just want one thing. Mama Jalmani Shuri Bhagatad Bhakti Raisvi. Life after life after life, I'm ready to take birth, but I just want one thing from you, which is I want your pure, unalloyed, uninterrupted, unmotivated, Ahituki Bhakti. This is the goal of every devotee in the. Every devotee should aspire for this Ahituki Bhakti. The Bhakti should be without motivation, without self-interest, without name and fame. I don't want to do my charitable service. Daily worship for name. Oh wow, Prabhu did such a beautiful shrimp. Oh Prabhu can do arti so good. Oh Prabhu can show the deep so elegantly and with such a good mudras and with such elegant way. No, this is not a desire. Only want Ahituki Bhakti. Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Bhaktra Vishwam Padam Toyam Eoge Bhaktya Prayat Chokhi Tad Bhakti Rukharita Masthami Prayatna. I only accept the offering of my devotee when it's offered with love and devotion. And how we can develop the love and devotion for Krishna? Lord Chaitanya says, tell us that, shows us that we can only develop the love of Godhead when we are not hankering for anything material and we are in the mood, we are serving each other, the devotee, to trump each other and Supreme God in the mood of the servant 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 of the gopis. Only we. Designation, the only identity of a devotee is Gopi, Bhatur, Bhatkamaliyor, Dasanu, Dasanu, Das. I am the servant of the servant of the servant of Sri Krishna. This is the only identity of a devotee. Krishna will not see what you are wearing, whether you are wearing dhoti, whether you are wearing kheda, whether you are wearing jeans. Yeah, externally we should wear dhoti, we should wear tilak, because in the beginning stage if we don't wear dhoti, don't wear tilak, we will not identify ourselves with as a devotee of Lord. This tilak shows the lotus feet of Krishna in our head, which means I am the servant of Krishna. When we wake up in the morning, we pay obeisances to the Guru, right? We pay obeisances to the Krishna, which means I am the servant of my Guru, I am the servant of my Krishna. In the very moment when I wake up, I am just hammering my head. Oh, you are not the Supreme. I am the Supreme. What am I? I am the servant of the servant of the servant of my Lord Sri Krishna. This is what we are doing, right? But Krishna will see the consciousness, what you are having. Prabhupada gave the name of is known as International Society for Krishna Consciousness, right? Prabhupada basically means it's Krishna Consciousness. The goal of every devotee should be, we should be Krishna conscious, right? And how one can become Krishna conscious? If you have other things in your heart, can you become Krishna conscious? Yes or no? Why? Because the pride is very strong. If you have pride in your heart, then definitely you can't be humble, right? If you have pride, you can't be humble. And if you are humble, you can't be pride. Right? Say this, Amma. Yes?
Yes.
Right? So then, when you are humble, then you can accept the authority of Krishna. Then you can develop the mood of Gopi, Bhattur, Patkamaliyo, Dasan, Dasan, Das. Then you can develop the mood, if you are humble, if you are really humble from inside, then you can develop the mood of Trinadapi, Sunichena, Karonapi, Shudishuna, Amanina, Manadena, Kirtanya, Sadhari. Then what will come after these two lines? Trinadapi, Sunichena, Karonapi, Shudishuna, since you are humble, right? Then when the humility takes place in our heart, then we develop a taste for Krishna's holy name. Then we chant the holy name constantly. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. Now the question comes, why are you chanting the holy names? Why? I'm only chanting the holy names for Ahetati Bhakti of Lord Sri Krishna to develop the mood of the servant of the servant of the servant, and I can serve Sri Sri Radha Madhava all the time, constantly. Chanting of the holy names is an offering of our love to Sri Krishna, right? And Krishna accepts an offering in one's condition. And I can tell you what is the condition? What is the condition? The condition is Vatram Pushpam Phalam Dayam Yone Vatya Pravenchati Tat Bhaktir Bharatam Prayasnami. That Bhaktir Bharatam and Bhadra Pusham Palantaya, my own Bhaktir Bharatri, that Bhaktir Bharatam, Asnami Prayasnami. Which means, I only accept, Krishna gave us many cards here, I only accept Bhadra, a leaf, specifically mentions here Tulsi leaf or any vegetables. But from Pushpam, Pushpam means flower. Patram Pushpam Phalam means water. Patram Pushpam Phalam Toya. Sorry, Patram Pushpam Phalam. Phalam means fruits. And Toya means water. So Patram Pushpam Phalam Toya is a main part of Krishna. And now question is, if you offer me those, then I will only accept that in one condition. And what is the condition? Tad Bhakti Uparitam Asnami Pradhyam, which means if my devotee offers me that with full love and devotion towards me, then will I accept that? And Krishna acts like that. You can see from Mahabharata. Where Krishna accepts the offering of Vidurani and rejects the Chapan Bhog. Right? Krishna accepts the offering of Vidurani, and Vidurani just offering banana. Right? And not even banana also. The peel of banana. Because when she saw Krishna, she developed, she went in ecstasy, asked Ashtashatmika, she went in samadhi, and unconsciously she's filling the bananas and she's throwing bananas and just offering and looking at Krishna's face and offering the peel of banana. And Krishna is accepting that. Krishna has already said that if you offer the love, then you accept. And that's pure love. No concern.
afternoon when we follow our Shishashri prayers. Cheto Darpanam, Cheto Darpanam Arjanam Bhavatma, Cheto Darpanam Arjanam Bhavatma Nirvapara, Shreya Kairava Chandrika Vidarna, Vidya Padhu Jeevana, Ananda Mudhi Vartana, Pratipada Purna Vida Sumadana, Sarvatma Sapanam Param Vijayate, Shri Krishna Sankirtana. So the Cheto Darpan Majana, the heart that cleans from all kind of dirt accumulated in so many lifetimes, in past lifetimes, in this lifetime, all the dirt, whatever dirt Dharma has.
Thus, when you read, write, illusion, and eat,
that dirt vanishes, it cleans when we take shelter of the devotee of the Lord, when we chant sincerely, when we follow the regulative principles, no illicit sex, no mating, no gambling, no intoxication. Actually, this four regulative principles makes us human being. And if you are not a human being, how do you perform bhakti? So first we need to become a human being. And then we can perform bhakti. And then Prabhupada gave us a very simple, minimum 16 hours. And in the beginning stage, 16 hours can be take 2 hours. Not more than 2 hours. Only 2 hours.
And out of 24 hours, you are only chanting for
2 hours. And by chanting 2 hours, we are aspiring to go back home, back to 200, right? And to just get admission in IITs and NITs, we are reading the mundane books. No offense to IITs and NITs. But we are studying for years. Not only a few months before the admission. We were from class 6, 7, 8. IIT. Preparation. And for praising Krishna, for serving Krishna is no liberation.
If your counselor or if your mentor tells you to chant 16 hours, you say,
16 round? My Lord, how will you chant 16 round? Okay, chant as many rounds as you can. But Lord Chaitanya says, Kheet Sanya Sada Hari.
We should chant constantly, 24/7.
We should be a fool. Prabhupada is so kind. He gives us minimum 16 hours. And if you can't give, if you are training yourself as a devotee of Lord Shri Krishna, and if you can't give 2 hours for Krishna out of 24 hours, then what you are doing?
You can watch movies for 3 hours, 2 hours. You can watch cricket for hours. If you can watch interviews for hours. If you can watch Doraemons and cartoons for hours. If you can watch TV serials for hours. Then can I give 2 hours to Krishna? Yes or no?
Yes.
Determine? You can give 2 hours? Having doubts and struggle? Or you are sure you can give 2 hours?
See, 2 hours is not very big deal, right? Sometimes you can see in the modern relationships of girlfriend boyfriend, they are talking for hours, more than 2 hours. And you are just talking with the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the Shri Krishna, who is the creator of the mundane world. The entire cosmic creation is coming from Krishna. He's the source of material world, he's the source of spiritual world, he's the source of everything. Each and everything is coming from Krishna. The sun is coming from Krishna, the moon is coming from Krishna, the earth is coming from Krishna, the vayu is coming from Krishna, the Indra is coming from Krishna, Brahma is coming from Krishna. Brahma is coming from the level of Krishna, the Mahavishnu. The Lakshmis are coming from Krishna. To give 2 hours for Krishna? You are giving your whole life for what?
for Akuri.
Right.
Right? For Anikal. You are doing IITs and IITs after all. What you will do with IIT and NIT degree? Certificate? No. You will do job. And by doing that job, what you will do? You will earn money, right? And you will lead a peaceful life. So ultimately, what you are doing? Money for money, right? Whatever profession you are doing it, for two things you are doing, earning money and name and fame. Whole material life conception is this. How to earn money, how to earn name and fame, how to have good sex. Right? This is the conception. Right? And money and name and fame is given by whom? Lakshmi.
Yes.
We worship Lakshmi, right?
This, what is this song?
Dhan, something like that. By worshipping you, I get the dhan, sampatti, something.
Lakshmi Aarti.
What is the song?
Dhan, sampatti ki mata.
Whatever it is. Dhan, sampatti, bhave, jub, jub, jive, something like that.
Yes.
Right? And Lakshmi's husband is? Who is the husband of Lakshmi?
Hare Krsna.
You are ignoring Vishnu, Krishna entirely and you are running through Lakshmi. Suppose your wife, maybe if you get married in future, we don't know if you have wife. So your wife, if anyone is calling a wife for function or invitation to welcoming them and worshipping your wife very brilliantly and ignoring you. Then your wife will be pleased with that. I don't know about modern wives, modern girls, but definitely I think 99% no, right? And we can see the example from Bhagavata. When father of Sati ignores Lord Shiva and dishonor him, Sati committed suicide, right? And the whole dynasty suffered like anything. Sati's father got the head of a goat. Right? Can anyone tell me the name of Sati's father?
Prajapati Daksh.
Prajapati Daksh for the, you should raise your hand. Prajapati Daksh got the head of a goat. Right? This is also an example of mental energy. When you speak about Krishna, then some comments just below. And this is what you have, this is a challenge. The problem will come. But you have to fight with the problem. You have to earn some light. The light is the Krishna's mercy and the Guru's mercy and the mercy of the Vaishnava in your life. The ray will come and give you some light. And you will chant, Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare.
Japa, or the, it's inattentive Japa, like looking at phone and also
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. This is a slim japa. Then there is one more japa. I used to call that japa as gallery view japa, which means it goes to a gallery. Gallery, you know what is gallery? The balcony. It goes to the balcony or the window. I used to say, what is going on? And you're chatting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Oh, masala, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. So, you know, what kind of japa is that? And another kind of japa is the angry japa, or in Hindi you can see it, Kundas japa. You know what is Kundas japa? The japa you do when you're very angry. Like you're chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. How dare you? You told me to chant 16 rounds. You know how much time it takes to chant 16 rounds. And you're not, if I don't chant 16 rounds, you will not recommend my name for initiation. And the Prabhu said, how can I recommend your name if you're not chanting 16 rounds? This is like a rule in the Prabhupada. Or sometimes there is the japa and vela taste. You know what is that? Like if you eat some karalas or the food you don't like. You don't have any taste. So if you do that kind of chanting, then definitely Krishna will not accept that. Krishna, what you are doing? Krishna has so many Lakshmi, so many gopis to serve him constantly. And what we are doing?
And
where to keep money? I don't have money. Where I will keep money? Really, I'm not able to handle money because I don't have the money. She's partially right. But few years back, one of my the Nani Shastra, so I went there. The Bhajan is completely changed. They said, I will make sannyas. And I will lead a life of Brahmachari and take very sannyas in a very young age and I will be fully devoted to Krishna. And he told me, don't ever dare to think to go out of bhakti. I said, why? Because I don't want to go, but I just asked him, why you are saying this? If you go, if you leave bhakti and if you go asana, Krishna will not allow you. He said, he didn't say Krishna, he said Vishnu. Vishnu will not allow you. And your mental life is completely destroyed. So see, birth charts can be changed. Krishna is the supreme personality of God, Ishvara Parama Krishna. And Krishna can do anything and everything. Nothing is impossible for Krishna. Krishna can reduce all your sin in just in 1 second. And Krishna can increase your karmic reaction in just in a second. But Krishna can increase, Krishna always increases. Krishna is very merciful. So yeah, that's it. Prabhupada said one time, devotee asked, how can I go back home? Back to God. When I will go back? How much time will it take? Prabhupada said, just a second. You chant the rounds, attentively, sincerely, with full love and devotion to Krishna, the pure and the Shuddha Naam you chant, and you will go back home, back to God immediately. You will become pure devotee immediately. Just by saying once, the Hare Krishna mantra, pure, if you take the Shuddha Naam, you will go back home, back to God. But I'm not giving you permission that you will just wait, you will wait for one time you will chant. No, it takes a lot of practice. There are three kinds of chanting: Namabhras, Namabhas, and Shuddha Naam. Namabhras is a beginning speech. We commit offenses against the holy names. And we should be read the 10 offenses against the holy names and the Chaitanya Shishtashtra prayers every day in the morning before chanting. And we should guard against all those offenses. And that comes when chanting. Group, like devotee group. It's very good for chanting in devotee circle. Keep the Tulsi man in the middle and sit in a circle and chant. That's very good. And then there's Namabhas. Namabhas is a speech when you are striving to chant purely and striving to not commit any offense. The practicing stage, striving stage is Namabhas. You are striving for not to commit any offense and striving for not to. Chant purely. And the Shuddha Naam is a stage when you chant always Shuddha Naam, the purely chanting, the with full of love and devotion. So there are three kinds of chanting. So, see, everyone can get the supreme perfection of human life going home, that's important. But for that, you have to do one thing. Lead your life according to the rules and regulation of the devotional life given by the Acharyas, the monophyte sampradaya Acharyas, like following the four rule principles, no eating, no gambling, no illicit sex, and chanting 16 rounds attentively every single day without fail. Do you fail to eat? Do you fail to eat? No. Do you fail to take oxygen? No. Do you fail to sleep every day?
No.
No. So then, you should chant 16 rounds attentively. Why? Because we are not these bodies. Are we these bodies?
No.
We are a spirit soul. And what is the proof? We are a spirit soul. When anyone dies, we used to say no. We used to try and reach a basar. He went. We say like that. People used to try, people used to say. Not only we, people used to say, right? Everyone used to say. People who say like that, right? And I saw many people, those who were really envious to him, they also cried. Chal basa. Maybe because of the happiness, I don't know, in the heart. But whatever is there, they used to say, the common thing is what they used to say, chal basa. Chala gaya. Kahan chala gaya? Kahan chal basa? Body to gali hai na? If we are this body is not there, why? So, kahan chal basa? Kahan gaya? Kahan gaya? Kidhar se gaya? Who went? Who left? body is still lying there.
Then who left? The soul. The soul left the body. So this is the proof we are the soul. I'm not saying this, this is there in the Bhagavad Gita also, but I'm telling you from the perspective of everyone in general. Right? And that is for sure. When you want to prove, you want to say, and you want to focus something, you say, as sure as that. Which means, I'm telling the truth, and that is confirmed. So, that's sure as that. Means that no one can. See, you are a devotee, you are a non-devotee. You are a Nastic, you are a Astic. You are a pure devotee, you are a Kanishka Adhikari. That is certain. Right? But death will come. You can't stop the death. But there are two kinds of deaths. First, for non-devotees, the death is like very, 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 very. It's like 100,000 of scorpions is biting you in one time. It's very, 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 supremely painful. Why? Like, now you can ask me how you can say that, right? So, you can see if a person is dying, anyone wants to die? No. Then why? Because there is a fear of the pain. And when a person dies, he cries out of prayer, right? He's not able to speak out of prayer. It's like a coma, right? He's not able to speak, he's not able to say, he just cried and he left. And for devotees, the birth is simply changing of the body. So, like, body is the clothes and he's changing that clothes. Like if you see, if a devotee passes away, I showed you in the video last class that Mataji is praying, Krishna and she smiles. And Govinda Madhish Purusham prayers are going on and she smiled and she looked at the photo frame of the deities and she said, and she left. With a smiling face. That is also there. Right? But for devotees, it's a change of your body. And how this will work? By wearing tilak, by wearing dhoti, by wearing kurta, by wearing kalsamala? No. By sincerely chanting of the holy names attentively throughout your life. From the time you came in touch with the devotees, from the time you came in touch with the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. You should be attentive. You should be chanting this mantra very, very sincerely, very, very sincerely. Spirituality is not about staying under a tree. Spirituality is not about staying under a palace. Spirituality is not about performing austerities. Spirituality is not about sense gratification. Spirituality is about how we can please Krishna, never forget Krishna, and always remember Krishna. Spirituality is about pleasing Krishna. Bhakti is about pleasing Krishna. Who is a bhakta? A bhakta is a person who performs bhakti. Who is a devotee? A devotee is a person who devotes his life for Krishna. Right? So, I request each one of you to chant the holy name very, very attentively, very, very sincerely. Minimum 16 rounds every day. And you can chant more than 16 rounds. But minimum you should chant 16 rounds every day without fail. Death is uncertain. You never know when death is going to come. And how could death not come? Padam padam yadvi padam natesha. Which means there is danger in every step of this mental world. But you can go out and few days back, few days or a month back, we heard the incident happened here, right? The Nagaji school incident.
Yes.
So many students got an accident, the car accident. So many students is going in the morning at 7 o'clock for school and in the car accident. 10 to 11 or 15 students die in just a moment of few seconds. Right? So we don't know when that is going to come. And what's the age of that students? Many people can tell you, bhakti is for elder person. Okay, bhakti is for elder person. Now tell me, the students who die, then what will happen to them? And
And what's their age? They're not in their 20s. They're not in their adult. They're in their teens, right?
Maybe 11, 10, 13, 14,
maximum 15, not more than 15. No one is more than 50 there. So what about them? They should not perform bhakti?
Why? Everyone can perform bhakti. Prahlad Maharaj, you see the example of Prahlad Maharaj?
From his childhood, he's an uncle. Drona Maharaj, he got perfection at a very early age. Right?
He's a child at that, right?
He got to climb his father's lap. And the father's lap is what a prahlad man. Father feels that he got so much hurt from his stepmother and he went to the forest. And under the guidance of Narada Muni. Perform the rules and regulation of Krishna without perfection within 6 months. You have to understand this thing very, very consciously. Very, very, what is called? Sincerely, that you can't perform bhakti, you can't approach Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, directly. You need to go through under some devotee. Or not some devotee, sorry.
You take me back, the words back.
You need to go under some pure devotee of God. A pure bona fide guru.
Yasya prasada bhagavat prasada, yasya prasada nagoti kutopi. Which means if you have the blessing of a pure devotee of the Lord, your spiritual master, you have the blessing of the Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And if you don't have the blessing of your spiritual master, the guru, then you will not get a tenth of place for yourself in the entire Chaudha Bhuvan, Chaudha Mandala. Where is Shurga Loka, Narada Loka, Tapa Loka, Chana Loka, Maha Loka? Not a single bed you will get a place. What about the spiritual life? What about spiritual bond? So you need to approach a guru and practice the devotional life under the direction of a bona fide guru. Like Srila Prabhupada is our all-time Shisha Guru in ISKCON and other spiritual master in ISKCON. You have to follow some guidance of some spiritual master. You need to be very, very attentive and report to your Shisha Guru, the counselor. Right? Because the counselor is a representative of your spiritual master. You need to be very, very attentive and chant the holy names constantly and practice. Chant as many rounds as possible. Not just 60 rounds, as many rounds as possible. Now the Kartik month is coming. You should perform bhakti 24 hours. You should perform bhakti 24 hours. Mm-hmm.
Perform bhakti for pleasure of Krishna. The austerity taken by
Radha Maharaj is saying. The austerity taken by a pure devotee, performed by a pure devotee, it's not for show. It's not for how much austerity I can perform. See my tolerance level.
No. The austerity performed by a pure devotee is out of love for Krishna. It's out of love for Shri Krishna. Right? So perform bhakti as much as possible. Take shelter of Krishna, take shelter of Prabhupada, take shelter of the spirit. Of the spiritual master, of your Diksha Guru. Without taking shelter of the spiritual master, without taking shelter of Prabhupada, you do not get the blessing of Krishna. Brahmata Narudhara Bhagavan Jati Guru Krishna Prasadi Bhagavad Gita. Without the mercy of Guru, you can't get the Bhagavad Gita. It's terrible. You need the mercy of Krishna and Guru both. And you will only get mercy of Guru, you will only get the mercy of Krishna when you have the mercy of Guru. And only you will get the mercy of Guru when you have the mercy of Vaishnavas. Right? So take shelter of Panchatattva, take shelter of Guru, take shelter of Vedasaka, take shelter of Advaitacharya, take shelter of Krishna, take shelter of Radharani, take shelter of Narasimha, take shelter of Prabhupada. It's very important. Taking shelter of Prabhupada is very, very important. And how can I take shelter? Just to bring obeisances? Yeah, that's very good to be obeisances to the Hindu. It's very good to be obeisances to Prabhupada. It's very, very good. But you should hear. You should hear the lecture. You should hear the lecture of Srila Prabhupada, you should hear the lecture of Srila Gurudev, you should hear the lecture of a special master. Every day. It's said in Bhagavatam, Nashta Parayeshu Abhadreshu Nitya Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Uttamasloke Bhakti Bhakti Ayatuki. Why? Nashta Parayeshu Abhadreshu. All the bad habits, all the contamination in your hearts goes away. Nashta Parayeshu Abhadreshu. All the Abhadrata goes away from you. Nashta Parayeshu Abhadreshu. When? Nashta Parayeshu Abhadreshu Nitya Bhagavata Sevaya. When you hear the Bhagavatam, constantly, always, every day, Nityam. Nashta Parayeshu Abhadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya. Bhagavate Uttama Sloke. Because the Bhagavatam describes about the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna, the Supreme Object, the Supreme Slokas are there in the Bhagavatam. Because it describes the Supreme Object, the Supreme Abode of all. Love. Sri Krishna. Object of all love is Sri Krishna. And supreme abode of love is Srimati Radharani. The Ashraya Vigraha, Srimati Radharani. We should take shelter of the Ashraya Vigraha, the Srimati Radharani. And we should perform bhakti by the mercy of Srimati Radharani and by the mercy of Srila Prabhupada, by the mercy of the Vaishnavas and the Guru, the Hari Guru and Vaishnavas. And we should perform the bhakti for the Vishaya Vigraha. Who is the Vishaya Vigraha? Vishaya Vigraha is the Sri Krishna. So we should be very sincere in our bhakti. Very, very sincere. We should, while chanting, we should be very, very sincere. Very, very sincere. Very, very sincere. Naam naam akare bahuda. The slow talks of Shishtashaka. Naam naam akare bahuda. निज सर्व शक्ति स्तत्रापिता नियमिता स्मरणेन कालः इतादृशी तव कृपा भगवन् ममापि दुर्देव विदृशामिहा जनानुरागः नाम नाम कार्य बहुधा निज सर्व शक्ति स्तत्रापिता कृष्णा हैव एम्पावर्ड हिज होली नेम विद ऑल हिज पोटेंसी कृष्णास होली नेम इज नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम श्री कृष्णा. If you are chanting the holy names itself with full love and devotion from your heart, then the Krishna present in your heart is Paramatma. You are always with Krishna. Because Krishna's holy name is not different from Krishna, and by taking shelter of Krishna, you are taking shelter of Krishna, and by associating, by chanting the holy names of Krishna, you are always associating with the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Then the Anashta Prayesha Vibration, Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya. Bhakti Bhavati Nashi. Then the bhakti gets fixed in our life. Bhakti Bhavati Nashi. Then the bhakti gets fixed in our life. Then we can, the determination comes in our heart. When we follow the four principles, then when we follow the rules and regulations of devotional life, then we perform bhakti sincerely. Take the message of Lord Chaitanya given by Srila Prabhupada very sincerely. Follow the four prohibited principles very, very sincerely. Chant 16 rounds every day very, very sincerely, very, very attentively. Serve the devotees. Take shelter of Bhagavatam is two. By reading Bhagavatam, by hearing Bhagavatam is one. And the second is serving the Bhagavatam. Serving Bhagavatam is serving the pure devotees of the Lord, because the pure devotees of the Lord molds their life in such a way according to the teachings, the conclusion of Srila Bhagavatam. So, yeah, perform bhakti very, very sincerely. It's a very rare gift you all achieve, you all catch. Brahma Dhinamite Gona Bhagavan Chief, Guru Krishna Prasad, if I bhakti lata beach, you already got the bhakti lata beach. Now you have to nourish that beach. Nourish that seed. Nourishing is from hearing. Shravanam is the first stage of bhakti. After Shravanam Kirtanam comes. Shravanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam. Then the Smaranam of Vishnu will come. Then you can remember Vishnu. Then you can remember Krishna. First we do these two things, Shravanam and Kirtanam. Take shelter of Shravanam. Hear his lecture every day. Give us a lecture of the spiritual path, your spiritual master every day, given the leadership of Srila Prabhupada every day. Don't sleep without chanting 16 rounds. Don't sleep or eat without chanting 16 rounds. Don't sleep or eat without hearing the leadership of Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada lectures are more than, not more than 35 minutes. It's always 30, 20, 25 minutes, 25 minutes, not more than that. Maximum 45 minutes. So hear his lectures. Perform all this listening attentively. And chant the holy names. Hare Krsna!